Hello YouTube family, it's Henny, and today I will be doing a request on the Loc Updo style. This request was for Miss Amy Ward, so if you stay tuned, we'll get started. First, we're going to start off by taking the locks from the back and combing them all the way to the front, and then we're going to do an inverted French braid, or overhanded braid as most people call it, up to about here, and then we're going to tie a lock from each side to secure that French braid, and then we'll work on the top. So I'm going to turn around and get started on that. So at this point, what we do is we comb all of our locks to the front, like so. Get it as smooth as you can, so we can start the inverted French braid. Now, I take three locks from the back row here, and as I'm braiding, I incorporate hair from the side into the braid, like so. I'm initially starting out, I do this loosely because you don't want to put a lot of tension on that last roll, because you want to be able to turn your head and take your head up and down without worrying about it pulling back here. So we just keep going up. And I wish I knew how to explain how to do an inverted French braid for those of you who do not know how to French braid, but hopefully you can see what I'm doing. Just adding hair to a section at a time while you're going over instead of under, like you would do in a traditional cornrow style or French braid style. Best way I can show you guys without taking and flipping my head upside down. Just keep adding hair from the sides as we go up. From the side, because we want the sides to be sleek. Just use your sense of touch. Sometimes I like to close my eyes when I'm braiding like this so that I can get a real feel for what I'm doing, but right now my eyes are not closed. So once you got all the hair on both sides, like so, this is a good stopping point. What we do to tie it off is take a lock from either side of that French braid to tie it off. And then just make a bow. I don't know what this is looking like in the back. Ah, I missed a whole entire lock almost there. Just tuck it in. Usually I'll have my mirror when I'm doing this so I don't do little silly things like that. So, don't laugh. But this is where we are now. Kind of funky 80s punk rocker thingy going, and all that's left to do now is to start tying your bows. Start tying your bows. And you tie your bows and do this over the holes. Section. You know what? I totally screwed that up. Let's start again. So now it's all
So now all we have left to do is to start tying our bows. Same general concept. Find two locks side by side. I'm going to retie this because it's feeling kind of loose and I do not like the way that feels. Tie our bows. We're going to do a double knot, but don't make that second knot so tight. Now, start tying the bows. Two locks. Ooh. Side by side. Start tying. Get to these. A little bit longer, traditional bow. Tuck these in. But basically, this is the whole concept of this updo. You're going to continue on doing this until you run out of locks on top of your head. And I know I'm being really sloppy right now. For time's sake, for showmanship, but in the end, it's going to be a beautiful, beautiful style. So I'm going to continue this. Get your bows however you want them. Placement is no big deal. Just make sure when you're doing your initial tying, you keep those two locks close together. Now this is not going to look exactly like it did in the initial little picture, but that's also beauties of updos. They don't always turn out the same way every time. Kind of like a unique factor with certain hairstyles. And Miss Amy, that's basically all you're doing. So I'm gonna do a few more of these. Well, off camera, and then I'll come back with the finished result. Okay, I just wanted to finish up these few on camera. And then our style will be complete. With these, I think I'm just gonna find somewhere to tuck them. These are a little longer, so I can do that traditional bow on these. And then as you see, I have an odd man out here because I did the same thing over here. When you come to One Lonely Rebel by itself, just tie the bow. Tie one bow, then with what you have left, tie another bow if you can, but if not, find somewhere to stick the excess. It's kind of loose, but I'm not gonna mess with it. Then like when you come to two that are too short for you to tie like we would regularly tie them, just make two individual loops and tie like so, and I'm just going to stuff those in. So now all that's left to do, once we've tied all our bows,
is to shape and mold and go back through and any little ones like these, find somewhere to tuck them securely. This is the style. I'm gonna turn around. This was detailed enough that you all will be able to try and accomplish this style. Thank you.